welcome back to my channel, and welcome if you are new. My name is Heidi. I'm a stay-at-home mom. I have three kids. Two are in school. My third one is on winter break, I guess, for college. I film during the day, mostly, because my kids are in school, and it's easier for me to film while they're in school because they both want to be the star of the show. And we all know that's me. I'm so glad that you're here today. I'm standing in my laundry room because today's video is laundry. And right now my washer's a little loud, I apologize, but right now I've got my undergarments and face mask washing on the delicate cycle. And then I'm going to be doing my Seth's laundry, and I'm going to be doing Bella's laundry. And there's a very little bit of laundry in my basket. I was gone this past weekend to visit a friend, and my husband did the laundry while I was gone, which is good and bad. Today's video is in collab with Love Jett. You can find her on YouTube at Love Jett. She makes cleaning videos, grocery hauls, organizing, everything that I make as well. We have so much in common. I'm a family of five as well as she, and we shop both at Walmart and Sam's. I really like her. She's very sweet, and I'm sure you guys are going to love her too. I'm so glad that you're here to watch this video, and I hope that I'm able to provide you with a lot of laundry motivation. So I thought I would try vlogging because I've never vlogged really before. I know I talk to y'all when I do cleaning videos, and sometimes I feel like I talk too much. So I just wanted to come on here and kind of tell you what's been going on with me the past couple of days. So yesterday I had to go to the ER. I was feeling lightheaded. I couldn't catch my breath, and my chest, I had a lot of pressure on my chest. And so I went, and this waiting room was so full. I don't know what it is about this time of year, but it's like people need to go to the emergency room and urgent care. And we have an urgent care in our city. And I went there first, and my O2, it's a percentage, and it's like your oxygen saturation, it was 82%. So normal is 94 to 100. You always want your saturation to be around 100. My son's asthmatic, and if his gets 94 93, he goes into a panic and starts having an asthma attack. And he can feel it when it goes low, because he's asthmatic. But getting back to what I was saying, so he came in and he said, I have pneumonia. So I feel a lot better today, and I haven't even gotten my antibiotic from the pharmacy. That's where I'm heading now, because when we got out of the ER last night, they were already closed. My pharmacy closes at 7, which is ridiculous. It's Walgreens, and you know, I'm sure big cities have 24-hour Walgreens. I know the city next to me, about 20 minutes away, their Walgreens is 24 hours. But whatever, that's what you get for being in a small city like me. So what I'm doing now is I'm gonna go to Walgreens and pick up my prescription. And they're actually doing COVID testing through the drive-thru, so I can't go through the drive-thru. I've got to go get out, you know, go inside. And then my husband and I, we did our ballots, our mail-in ballots. So we have voted, and I'm gonna go and take these to the post office. Just for you, for those of you that are not aware, the fact that you vote is public knowledge. Anybody can go on the internet and see that you're a registered voter. Who you vote for is private. There is nothing saying that you have to discuss that with anybody. And if anybody ever asks you, you just say, I'm sorry, I'm not comfortable talking about that. I've had people ask me in the past, and that's what I've told them. I'm not comfortable talking about that, because politics is a very sensitive subject matter. Politics and religion. So I try to avoid those conversations if at all possible. So I think I'm gonna go to the post office first and drop these off so I don't forget. And then we are gonna head over to Walgreens. Another thing I want to talk about is Christmas and Christmas presents. So I have three kids. My oldest is 23, and then my middle child is 13, and my youngest is 9. She will be 10 on December 23rd. So I want to know, with the parents that have multiple kids, do you have to count your presents and make sure that like Seth and Bella, I have to count their presents and make sure that they have the same number of presents. Because it is mainly Bella. She will get so tore up if her brother has more than she does. Elora, she's 23, she don't care. As a matter of fact, she helped me wrap presents and she wanted to wrap her own. I remember doing that when I was younger. I did it one time and it was depressing. So it's because my mom is not a very good shopper. But it was depressing, so I never did it again, ever. I just helped wrap my siblings' presents and not mine. And my kids do ask every now and then if they can help wrap their siblings' presents. But I have OCD like nobody's business. And the way they wrap drives me crazy. But 2020 has been a very rough year for me. I'm sure it's been for everybody. But I have developed this this disease in my spine, and it is the most painful thing that I feel like anybody can go through. I know some moms are like, no, childbirth is. Well, I've been through childbirth 3 times. This back pain, okay, childbirth, it goes away. It's not constant. My back is constant. It's every day. It's every hour of every day, every night. I can't sit for a long time. I can't stand for a long time. I can't walk for a long time. If I do a lot of bending over and coming back up, like you have to do when you clean a house, yeah, it kills me. The pain is just so excruciating. And sometimes I just want to give up on this whole YouTube thing. I love doing it. I love filming. I love messaging you guys. I love talking to y'all, whether it's on YouTube or Instagram. I love it. But sometimes it is a struggle for me to get up and do some work so that I can film it. And yesterday I didn't do nothing because, you know, I was not feeling very well. And today I'm not feeling any better, really. My back is hurting me right now. So. Okay. I just got back in the car, you guys, and it is cold. My car says 42, but I seriously think it's lower than that. I got my prescription. I dropped off my ballots. And now I'm gonna go home and make me some cheese toast because I haven't eaten breakfast, and it's 10:19 in the morning. Ooh-wee, Mr. Sun. So a week or so ago, I had made a video where I had talked about needing to get my nails done. And I got my nails done, but I haven't. And then somebody asked me that, or, you know, made a comment that would love to see my nails. So there you go. This is SNS. I do have tips because my nails, and this happened way before I started getting nails on, but my fingernails are very weak and they break easy. So by the time I had gone back, all my fingernails had broken off. Like the S&S fingernail had come off. You can't see it very well because of the sun, but it had come off, and my real nail was long, but it was brittle and weak, and I ended up just kind of trimming it a little bit just to make it the size that I like it, because I don't like long nails. Like, these are getting way too long. Look how long they are. You can see them over my fingers, and that to me is just way too long. So I like the short ones that barely peek over your fingertips. I know I'm weird, but when they're long like this, I jam them so much more than when they're shorter, and it hurts. So I can't do anything until after Christmas, just because the kids are going to be home, and I'd rather go when I don't have the kids. So when they go back to school, I will get my nails done. Okay, so I wanted to show you what I mean by cheese toast. I'm gonna set my oven to 350, and I just want two pieces, so I put two pieces of bread, and then here's my cheese. So I'm gonna take this, unwrap it, and lay it on my bread. So now I'm gonna bake this just long enough for the cheese to melt and the bread to get toasty. You want it to be toasty, not burnt or too crunchy. Of course, you make it how you like to eat your toast. If you want it almost burnt, or, you know, however you want it. But I'm just gonna cook mine long enough for it to get crunchy. Okay, my first load of laundry is done. Sorry, the phone's moving. But I've completed my first load, and I'm gonna go ahead and take my bras and some face mask, and I don't like to wash them on regular cycle. I like to do them on delicate. So I'm going to take them out now and hang them up on the hanger behind me, and then I'm gonna go get Bella's clothes and start. On a hanger, but I have so many, I'm just gonna lay them all out here, and hopefully by the time this is done, they'll be dry. My husband's been messing with these buttons on the washer, and I'm really frustrated with him because now the timer's messed up. So what usually would take an hour to wash or better, it says 56 minutes. So I don't even know if that's going to be enough time to clean these clothes the way I want them clean, but I guess we will see. I'm very frustrated with my husband. He's always touching stuff that he don't need to touch.
here says laundry, so I will be doing that. This is
the way I like mine. They're crunchy, like they've been through the toaster, and the cheese is melted, but they're so hot, so be careful.
Go outside, the snow is falling down, and every child is having so much fun. The snowman is twice the size as me, with a smile as quirky as mine. We're holding hands to keep each other warm while we stand and watch a choir perform, and all the Christmas songs that we love. Yeah, all the Christmas songs that we love. And in a while we're gonna go inside and drink our chocolate by the fire. Cause all I want is to spend this day with you. Let me give you a Christmas, a moment we'll fill with love and joy. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe, baby, with you. I don't need any presents, as long as I spend this day with you. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe, baby, with you. Ooh. I'm making plans of what we're gonna do. I feel so blessed that I can be with you. Cause God knows that I've been longing for ya. I just wanna hold you close. You know the stars are shining just for you. Let's take a walk and we can follow the moonlight till we reach a place we can stay. Maybe kiss a bit and dream away. And in a while we're gonna go inside and drink our chocolate by the fire. Cause all I want is to spend this day with you. Let me give you a Christmas, a moment we'll fill with love and joy. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe, baby, with you. I don't need any presents, as long as I spend this day with you. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe, baby, with you. And in a while we're gonna go inside and drink our chocolate by the fire. Cause all I want is to spend this day with you. Let me give you a Christmas, a moment we'll fill with love and joy. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe, baby, with you. I don't need any presents, as long as I spend this day with you. So beautiful, kissing on a mistletoe, baby, with you.
Christmas cake, and then we go skating on the frozen.
constantly saying hi to every friendly.
Okay guys, I am finished with the laundry. I did Bella's clothes. Seth's clothes are in the dryer, and I'm gonna wait until he gets home and let him take them out and fold them and put them away. He's 13 and I'm trying to teach him responsibility. I'm trying to teach him how to keep a house clean, because when he grows up and moves out, whether it be college or somewhere else, I would feel more comfortable knowing that my life lessons to him is instilled in his mind. My back is hurting on a scale from 1 to 10. You know how they ask you in the hospital? It's a 10. It hurts, and I don't know if it was just from folding her clothes, but I think I'm gonna lay down and kind of take it easy for the rest of the day. I hope you all have a wonderful week and weekend, and a very Merry Christmas, and I will see you at the next one.